The real main event. I think we can all agree on that at this point. Kazuchika Okada and his amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat versus Bryan Danielson and his eye patch. This match was everything I want pro wrestling to be. Everything I want pro wrestling to be. It was technical. It was scientific. It was thoughtful. It was strategic. It was brutal. It was violent. It was athletic. It was cruel and sadistic on the part of both men. My favorite Bryan Danielson is cruel, sadistic asshole Bryan Danielson. And boy, do we have that here. They're fighting on the floor very early on. And Okada wants to do a giant running move. Such a giant running move, he actually jumps onto a platform 40 feet away from Danielson so that he can jump back down and run at him. But it was a poor plan. Danielson caught him on the coming in with the knee strike that he has won so many matches with. And then he just begins to target the arm. He's slamming into the guardrail repeatedly. He's slamming the guardrail door onto it repeatedly. Takes him in the ring. Hits a hammerlock. Northern Light suplex for two. And Okada gets a brief comeback there. Air raid crash. But he gets suplex off the top rope. Gets into the bell lock. Okada quickly got the ropes that time. The first, the bell lock. Okada got the ropes very quickly. Then Okada comes back. Hits the tombstone on the apron. Trauma to the head. And, of course, Danielson was once forced to retire due to concussion issues and is currently suffering from a broken orbital bone. And so Okada gets him in the ring and lays him out in this corner. And now Okada is the cruel, sadistic asshole in this match. He's stomping him right in the eye with complete disdain. He's stomping this like the way you try to put out a fire, a fire that would not die, and you're desperate for that. He doesn't want to be there. It's beneath him to kick this man, but he hates him so badly he wants to kick him in the face. Just complete the disdain for the man as he's taunting him. Tears off the eye patch because he's a dick, a huge dick, this Kazuchika Okada. And then, seen 100 Okada matches, and the best thing is, he has the best dropkick like ever, but it's just a dropkick. There's nothing magical about it. He just jumps very high and kicks me in the face. The magic thing is how he always manages to find a way to hit it when you're not expecting it. And you think you're ready for it, and you think you're watching for it, but that's not it. He always waits for the exact right moment when you're not expecting it, and that's when he delivers it. Except in this match, because he stomps Bryan in the eyeball about 18 times, and just pulls him up, whips him into the ropes, jumps very high, and dropkicks him in the eyeball with both feet. That was that. There's the Okada dropkick out of the way. Now, he hits the dropkick, but upon landing, he clutches his arm. His arm has still been worked over, and when you do a dropkick, of course, you come down on your arm. So he damages his own arm doing that. Then he goes up to the top rope. He does the top rope Macho Man elbow and hits it, but then he just collapses. He is writhing in pain and grabbing his arm. And when Danielson did his promo, vowing that he would break Okada's arm so Okada could not do the Rainmaker. For a second, I actually thought he meant Okada would not be able to do the Rainmaker pose. Now, of course, he meant the Rainmaker clothesline, the finisher for Okada, but there's also the pose with the same name. And at this point in the match, after hitting this top rope elbow and collapsing and grabbing his arm, Okada collects himself, gets to his feet, hangs his head, and does the big Rainmaker pose. But then as the camera zoomed all the way out, that right arm drops. And Okada is standing in the middle of the ring with one arm stuck straight out and one arm hanging limp, loose, impotent down by his side. So Danielson fires back and he's throwing kicks. Okada blocks a kick with the bad arm. Of course, that hurts. He drops his arm. So Bryan throws another kick, and this one is blocked with the face, which is not actually a block. It's taking damage, and it hurts really bad. Danielson begins to hit the hammer and anvil elbows. He's raining them down from the heavens. He's not a big man, but he's bringing that elbow up as high as it will go. He's dropping as fast as it will go over and over and over again. And Okada's the much taller and the much bigger man. He powers up out of this. But Dragon escapes whatever he's going for. He gets a knee strike, gets a two count off that, and as Okada kicks out, Bryan goes right for that lapel lock. And man, now Okada is fucked. He He's fighting and fighting and fighting. And they transition out of that two or three times, but Danielson keeps getting it back. And then he gets the same leg-based arm lock on the fly finish that he won with at Forbidden Door with a broken arm. At this point, this building is just going insane. And this match is so wonderful. And they're in the middle of the ring. And there is a long struggle. I mean, a long struggle. And Okada's, both his arms are pinned behind his back. Can't do nothing. Can't do nothing. Helpless. And he's virtually crying. He is hanging his head. Multiple times, he appeared to be on the verge of passing out from the pain and before resurfacing and coming back to life. And he finally, and I mentioned he's much taller than Bryan. He has very long legs. And he finally throws out one of those very long legs and just barely gets to the ropes and saves the day. This just pissed Bryan Danielson off. He begins to stomp Okada very hard in the face. He's doing the Blackpool Combat Club stomp. So you grab both wrists to stomp the guy's head. Only he's like following through. Like if there was a head below the mat, he was trying to stomp that. And Okada's head was just an obstacle in his way to pass through on the way to his true target. Just stomping him over and over again. And Okada somehow escapes that. Gets a Rainmaker, the clothesline, out of nowhere. Collapses in a heap. Both guys are on the verge of death at this point. And they're doing a strike exchange, only they're not trading chops, and they're not trading elbows, they're not trading punches. Every strike Danielson throws is a kick to the presumably broken arm. And every strike Okada is throwing is a boot to the legitimately broken orbital bone. It is just kick to arm, boot to face. Kick to arm, boot to face. Kick to arm, boot to face. Okada tries another Rainmaker. Danielson boots him in the arm, hits his big knee strike, and he goes to the corner. And this is Bryan Danielson's highest profile match. Well, for, I think his first match in the... Well, I think the WWE did Japan, but it's his first Tokyo Dome main event. And the first time we've seen the American Dragon Bryan Danielson in a match this prominent in Japan since WrestleMania. And this crowd immediately knew what he was going to do. And for a brief moment, he morphed back into Daniel Bryan. And he begins to lead the crowd in chants of yes, yes, yes. And the crowd is chanting along. They're very happy. Yes, yes, yes. They're all chanting. But then Danielson misses the knee coming out of the corner, lands on his ass. They go back and forth. He tries another knee strike. It is met with the magic dropkick of death. And Okada follows with the landslide. Hits one more Rainmaker, which may in fact have broken his arm. Because he fell on top. And he gets the win. And then he just can't move. And as was pointed out by Dave Portivo on our board, in the end, sports entertainment was Brian's downfall. It all went wrong when he went to that corner and tried to do yes chants. If he just went back to more submission-based ground wrestling, could have had this guy. A beautiful, beautiful wrestling match. Bryan Danielson's the best wrestler in the world. It's just been not quite 1 year. It's like 51 weeks since his match with Takeshita in AEW, which was followed shortly thereafter by the Iron Man match against MJF, and then the strap match with Ricky Starks, the first Okada match at Forbidden Door, and I'm getting the timeline wrong here, bear with me, the Zack Sabre Jr. match at Wrestle Dream, and then, of course, everything that happened in the Continental Classic, and I'm pretty confident this has been the best 365 days of a wrestler I've had the pleasure to witness. It has been glorious and wonderful, and I will never forget it. It was awesome. That match ruled. That match ruled.
Hey guys, did you love this clip? If so, you should join our channel. Just hit the join button and you'll have full access to every single show that we do. Wrestling Observer Live, Wrestling Observer Radio, The Bryan and Vinny Show, all of them in full HD, full length, plus archives of all of your favorite shows. Click join today and don't miss out.